Hi, I'm Kathy Barker from Software Solutions, and you're looking at one of a collection of my Power BI videos. And we're looking at creating reports and visualizations. Please like or subscribe, and let us know how we're going. What I'd like to do now is show you another visual that's extremely popular in Power BI, and that's a matrix. A matrix is very much like almost a pivot table in Excel, where you have columns and you have rows, and where the two intersect, you basically have some sort of aggregate value. You've summed something, you've averaged something, or you've counted something. What I would like to do is go to our on order page, and in this page, I actually want to create a matrix visual. So, looking at your visualizations, we've just looked with table before. Now we're working with matrix. So, I click that particular visual. I can move it if I wish, and I can resize it as well. Now it says to select or drag fields to populate this visual. And if I look at the visualizations pane, I've got a rows bucket, a columns bucket, and a values bucket, much like a pivot table. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go and open up the DIM products query, and I want to grab the product name and I want to put this in my rows. So I just drop it in rows. And so now I see a unique instance alphabetically listed of every product. Now what I want to do is close the products and open up the DIM categories query and grab category name to my columns. And so I now have a unique instance. Let me just stretch this out. A unique instance of each category as my column headings in alphabetical order. I'll now close that particular query and I want to grab now the units on order, which is in my products table. Units on order, and I'll drop that into my values bucket. And so now I'm actually seeing that we have got 70 units of aniseed syrup currently on order, which falls into the condiments category. All right. So that's how we create a matrix, and we can resize it and see as much. And it totals the columns and it totals the rows, and it's a very popular way of viewing. And I might just zoom out a little bit and make it take up more of the page. So I've got this much space that I could utilize on the page. All right. Now I actually want to sort this information by total in descending order, so I can see which product I have the most units on order. So I click on total, and here I can see Louisiana Hot Spiced Okra is the product that I have the most units on order, and that is 100 units on order. Now I don't need to see a lot of these products that have got 0 units on order, so I want to filter, and so I'm going to expand my filters pane. Here I can see that I've got category name, product name, and units on order. All of the elements that have been used by that matrix, because I have that matrix selected. If I click away, they disappear. As soon as I click back on the matrix, they reappear. Now I'm seeing all of the units on order. If I hit this chevron and open up this filter card, I might change this to give me all the ones that are greater than 0. And I'll apply the filter so that I'm not getting a whole lot of information that really is irrelevant. And I'll apply the filter. And so now my matrix is basically just showing me those products that have got some units on order, but it's also sorted them that the one that has the most units on order is at the top. So use your filters pane. Matrixes are very, very popular.